read it, I'll be honest, I was like, oh, I don't know what's special about this. Like, I didn't really understand what was special about the play, and I was like, oh, I don't, why is this so popular? Until it was read out loud, and then the words coming off the page became, like, family almost, and just that feeling of when you're in a room and you're, like, connecting with them, and, like, we do when we're laughing and just, like, goofing
like
off.
Right now.
Right now. And it, I don't know, there's just something, and you're just so ridiculous, and you're, you are where you are in your life in this moment, and you're just dealing with it together, and there's something so funny, but, like, communal and human about that. Yeah.
How many times in rehearsal have we stopped to say, this is a Steel Magnolias moment?
Yes.
We weren't talking, we weren't doing lines from the play. Mm-hmm. We were just talking to mm-hmm. each yeah. other in that environment. And then we said, oh my gosh, this is a Steel moment.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and it went Tom and Gary came walking in and said, I was mad today when I walked in here, and now I'm not mad anymore.
Yeah.
So,
yes.
Yeah. And that happens.
And I think it's because this story is so true. Mm-hmm. It is so honest, and it is so true. And, you know, if art imitates life, this does it in the most wonderful way, I
think. Absolutely.
So, yeah, that could be why we keep finding ourselves in Steel moments.
And it was already such a play that was so powerful, but learning that all of this is based from the playwright's actual happenings in his life.
Yeah.
It's just like it can't be anything but honest. Mm-hmm. You know, and it was when Katie Brown was talking about, why do so many plays try to imitate this play? Do the funny Southern women, like, this is just, every single person is based in truth mm-hmm. to its core. And it's just
right, but
so
it wasn't originally set up to be a comedy.
Right.
You didn't write it to be a comedy. It just is.
Yeah.
Because these women are funny.
Yeah.
And
because these ordinary things that, you know, like, we come into a play thinking, like, today is important because it's the most important day because, and there are things in this play that are seemingly kind of unimportant and just every day, but they are important because they're real.
Yeah.
And because every day that we exist is the realest to us, you know, and, like, the most important to us. And so these women coming in and getting their hair done, even though they get it done every week, like, it's important to get this information to them and talk about what their life is like.
Something that is equally, if not almost most important, that we've already touched on. We refer to he, the playwright. The playwright was a man, which to me says that this is not exclusive to women, mm-hmm. that this is not just a woman's story, that that men as well as women find these friendships, find these bonds that they come to depend on mm-hmm. with all their heart, and that these people do become family. So I think that's one of the beauties of it. It was written by a man, and who, of course, knew these women very well, but nevertheless, he brought them to life. And so I think he has an understanding about the inexclusivity of the story.
I think, like, the finding your tribe is sort of
universal. That's a good way to put it.
And that they're from so many different, like, I think of, like, my own personal life, like, the people in my life that are my little tribe of people are, like, different ages and all from all over the place and total different backgrounds. And that's what I think is cool about this, that it's, like, they're not all of the same person at all.
Right, yes.
But that what they get from each other. And to me, what's nice about this, which is, like, this, I guess, microcosm of what I think theater can be, is like an illustration of what we can be for each other, and what they all, like we talked about in rehearsal when Katie was saying, like, what alloy creates steel.
What
we can all be to each other to fortify one another.
Indestructible unit because of the differences that we
have.
It is. It's like they're in each other's bones. Like they like sort of like get, like they know the bones of every person in the room. And they're all so, and I think it's why, like you said, it wasn't written as a comedy. Like, the reason it works as a comedy is no one's trying to be funny. Like, no one, like, they all want to hang out because they all find each other so funny. But I don't know that Truvy is funny to anyone else.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, I don't think, like, her husband and her sons ever think that she's funny at all.
Yeah.
And so she's in this room with these people.
Yep.
And, like, she's like, oh, did I just make a joke?
Yeah.
You know, like,
yeah.
It's so funny that. Like
it's like, yeah. I feel like. like this, her beauty salon is her stage. I don't know. It's like the place she gets to perform for people.
Well, and everyone has their own. There's like all these moments, I think, like that everyone has, like, it's like passing the baton around for who's like playing Mama Bear at any given time.
That's how,
like, everyone has their own, like, this isn't a cheesy
thing to say,
but like the five love languages, like everyone has their own love language too within the friendship of like, here's the service I can provide. Or like, here's, like, there's something to the fact that like Malin comes in and says, oh, I must look horrible at the end of the play. Can you do my hair? Mm-hmm. And like, that's like, I know how to do that.
Yes.
That's how I can do this.
Yeah.
But it's, or like, you know, showing up with tomatoes. Like, here, have the stuff that I grew. But I don't know.
That I don't want.
Right.
I want you to have it because I want you to be healthier than I am.
Yeah.
See, that's giving.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true. Generosity at its finest. I can't wait to see you in overalls.
Oh.
Yes.
This
does
is
it
true.
Seed packets on it?
It what?
Does your hat have seed packets on it?
It did once upon a time, but it doesn't now.
Okay.
Is it weird doing it again? Is
weird?
It so strange doing the show again?
No. I love doing this show. I love telling this story. So I was very lucky that I had another chance to do this.
I'm so excited.